especially these days, most of us are trying to stay healthy in one way or another, whether it's eating the right foods or going to the gym or a combination of the two. I mean, we all think we know the basic ground rules of staying in shape. But what you might find surprising is that your feet, more importantly, your shoes, can actually play a huge role in your overall health and the way you look. We sent celebrity trainer, her name is Ashley Borden, to a local gym to see if the people there were putting their best feet forward. Watch.
Hi. Hey, hi, I'm Ashley. Do you mind if I talk to you real quickly about your shoes and what's going on here with your cardio?
Sure.
You do know these are not running shoes. These might be cute to wear to the store. Do you have any body pain?
Yeah, I get shin splints all the time, and sometimes in my hips.
Huh? Do you feel it in your back and your neck at all?
A little bit in my back, sometimes in my neck and my knees.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I thought that was normal.
No. Go ahead and walk to normally looking forward. You have a lot of forward head carriage, which means that when you stand, you're standing like this. Because you have a little bit of a collapse in your arch, your hips rotate inward, okay? So when your hips rotate inward, it brings the tush out. We're gonna go ahead and find some shoes for you, have you try them on, and feel which one feels like the right pair for you.
Okay.
We're giving you much more of a stability in your shoe. You're looking at the gray buildup through here, so this is what stabilizes your foot. I picked out one that has a little bit more width to it. These, if you see, these are much more narrow, okay? And you can see how your shoe is pushing out on the side.
Yeah.
From here. I think we found your ruby slipper, so let's come stand and let me have you walk. Why don't you walk this way?
I already feel a little bit more energized with these on.
Oh, that is exactly what I want to hear. And you're standing up so much straighter. That's perfect.
It feels a lot more cushiony. I feel straight.
Yes! Your form is like night and day. All right, I'm gonna let you finish your run. Nice
Yay.
Work.
See ya. Now that I have the proper footwear, I think that I will be able to get back into bikini body shape much quicker.
I have a question. How old are your shoes?
They're like circa 1999, so like 10, 12 years old.
This is the first official time I've met somebody with shoes that old.
I'm so embarrassed.
Now, why are you wearing 10-year-old shoes?
Well, because I have really small feet, so it's a pain to actually find good-fitting shoes.
Do you have any body pain of any sort with your shoes?
I have bad knees, especially my left one.
Okay.
And then I know my ankle has issues sometimes.
Okay, and I want to find the right shoe for you, for your foot size. It looks like you have a little bit of a wider foot. So let's take these dinosaurs off. Usually a tread won't wear down before the shoe structure will wear down. The other thing is you can take the middle of a shoe and push down to see if it's real super flexible in the center of it. It should not be, yours is. But that's what also gives a lot of people joint pain. Now these are a Brooks shoe that are also a DD width, meaning they're a wider width shoe. Yes. Oh, I feel better already looking at them. How does your body feel in the shoes?
Feels good. My foot feels like it's got a lot of cushioning and support. Well, now that I know, I probably buy my next pair of runners in less than 12 years. I feel really comfortable with these shoes. I like to do a marathon.
So, sitting with me live and having a giggle next to me, this is Ashley Borden, everybody. We were just talking about, I didn't know they even made size 4. She wears a size 4, ladies.
She wears, yes, but she was getting children's shoes because she didn't know, they don't normally sell a size 4 in the running stores, but you can get them made. Yep. They'll actually special order for you, but she didn't know that.
Yeah, there's so much that people don't know about, how to buy proper fitness shoes.
Absolutely.
And I want to get to some tips on that in a second, but first of all, What would you guess is the number of people out there in the gym today that, you know, they have foot problems and they just don't even know it?
Honestly, I would say about 90% of people are completely disconnected from what's going on down here, from their shoes, what's going on with their feet, what they should be wearing. I mean, it's an enormous number.
We saw the shoes. Are there any other tricks? I mean,
yes.
Does socks matter?
Socks matter. I actually took the girls, some of the girls were wearing like cotton socks that were sliding down and getting blisters. So you wear socks midway through your workout, you're like, What, my sock has disappeared and my shoe ate it.
Right,
when you're wearing the right sock, A, you can last so much longer doing your cardio because you don't get blisters.
Right.
They make socks with a breathable fabric so your foot doesn't feel like it's suffocating.
Right.
The other thing is you can get what's called an insert an orthotic in your shoe. Like if you don't want to go and get a whole new shoe right now.
Is that what these are?
Exactly. So I brought two different types here. This one is a hard orthotic that you can go to your podiatrist.
Okay.
And what they'll do is they'll do, there's a couple ways to do it. They'll do a paper mache of your foot, and they'll actually do like a specific orthotic for your foot issue, or they have you like step into a little cushion and they'll send away and give you a hard orthotic that you put into your shoe, you take your little tongue out. Or this is something kind of similar, but this is actually, what's cool about these is that they have kiosks all around the United States now where you can go, you take your shoes off and you stand on it and it will give you a feedback based on where your body weight is on the floor of what type of orthotic you need. So if you can't go to a podiatrist or it's too expensive because it can be sometimes costly.
This is very affordable.
So affordable, and it'll give you exactly the type of orthotic you need. You cannot wear your friend's orthotics.
And then you just pull out the insert that comes with your shoe and pop this in.
You don't want to put it on top of the insert that's already in there. You want to put it inside in replace of that.
And we were discussing while we were watching the tape that all over the country there are stores that will watch you run.
Yes.
So the next time you do invest in shoes, do a little research online or ask around in your community or your town or your city, because there are stores, like here in New York, there's a thing called Jackrabbit.
Right. I'm sorry. No,
go ahead.
Absolutely, because a lot of people will think, well, I'm not a runner. I don't need to go to a specialty running store. In L.A., we got a lot of these from Arch and Soul. Nike Town will do it. You can go to, you want to look up what a specialty running store is where somebody actually knows how to, what it's called analyze your gait. So they'll watch you walk and they'll say, okay, I see you're pronating or you're supinating, you're collapsed or you're walking on the outside of your feet. These are the right shoes for you.
And they'll help you make the right choice the next time you are going to make an investment in a whole new shoe.
It makes such a huge difference. When you run or walk in the right shoe or train in the right shoe, it feels like you are standing on a cloud.
Yeah, and you end up working out longer and therefore looking better.
You're right.
So, up next, great job, by the way.
Thank you.
Up next, we're gonna check in with Christina. She is a girl who really understands this struggle of weight and life change. She's a teen who's been fighting to lose 70 pounds by her prom. That's after this.
Wow.